Maybe the peace greeting is not appropriate in this case. And even my wife has looked at the time I've taken to record two of these, both of which were over an hour. And that's time I've taken away from her. Now, I could take those recordings and then go ahead and turn them into a video, but even that on my laptop would take a long time. So I figured better to just go ahead and try to do a short one. So for what I leave out, I'm sorry. And for anything that I've left out, feel free to kindly ask me about it in the comments and I'll get back as quick as I can. But as I've stated before, I will be busy. Tomorrow I got a double shift. Monday I've got a double shift. And then Monday afternoon, I will then start a class in which I am a student. And I will have to take that one every day into the first week of December when I'm done teaching my own students. I'll be busy. My son also starts an apprenticeship, so to the bros listening, please supplicate to the king on his behalf and then on mine. This is inspired by Smiles and a Twisted MD. There's something for which I have to take accountability. I've always said, you know what, when we men are guilty, take accountability, but never take accountability when you're not. And don't take accountability for things you didn't do, nor for which you had no control, nor for which you had no knowledge of a better option. And even if you take accountability, sometimes you have to do it privately, but not publicly. In this case, I'm going to do it publicly for the sake of fairness, because I've talked about fairness and justice. Even when I say that it's fair to be one-sided in the gender war of the wider BC. And I have said that, well, because that's what I've observed. In this case, there's something for which I got to take accountability. Starlight and Smiles and a Twisted MD pointed out a video that I put up in response to Anon and LSM back when they were online. And I was trying to walk the listener through my development as a pro-black who did not know what they knew about colorism within the black population of the United States, as defined by the one drop rule, I mean. I was trying to walk them through what I had learned, and I wanted to give them credit for what I'd learned from them. And I also wanted to give credit to even the detractors who had brought receipts for what they had said in history, because I used to be a history teacher, believe it or not, in grade schools in the States. I don't know everything, but I had to know the things that were in the curriculum for those grades, mostly middle school. And even though I can't remember the names of the acts that were, in fact, housing discrimination, when I hear the names of these acts, I'm able to recognize them, even though I can't recall them and bring them back up. I was trying to be fair. Notice, I wasn't perfect, but I was trying to be fair. And so as I walked the listener through the stages of my pro-blackness, I told them how my teenage ideas. And in one of these lines, I said, unfortunately, my daughters came out light skinned. Now, keep this in mind. I was talking about, as a teenager, I would have thought, okay, unfortunately, they have this burden on them. They have to face the difficulty. That's what I would have thought as a teenager. I thought that was obvious that's what I was getting at when I recorded it, and I was talking fast. Nope, my mistake. I didn't make it plain that that's what I was getting at. That's not why I was saying unfortunately. Now, as an adult, which I was when I had all of my children, there is nothing unfortunate about any shade. There are burdens that come with some of them, depending on your gender and your region, but there was nothing unfortunate. It's not a birth defect. So, and I thought that people knew this about me, but I didn't make it obvious. Okay, you know what? A lot of people that didn't know me were listening, and I didn't expect that many who didn't know me to be listening. Starlight and Smiles did not know me well at the time. Funny thing is, Smiles didn't know that I was a father until recently, but she remembered that video. That just came to me now as I was speaking. If you don't remember that I was a father back then, I mean, if you didn't know that I was a father back then, how do you recall the video, which was from 2020? You know what? Maybe she'll never hear this. If you do, Smiles and a Twisted MD, feel free to answer in the comments. I would go live and give you a chance to come up, but because of time constraints, I mean, I'm going to be busy even later on this evening. So that's why I didn't. I got one last evening to spend with my wife. One last afternoon, I should say, to spend with my wife before I get busy for days. So I'm going to try to do this justice while keeping it short. I'm taking accountability for that. Not that it's actually unfortunate or that I even meant that, but I didn't make it plain and obvious. Now, that year, I knew things I did not know in 2019. Additionally, I know things now I did not know back then. And I've given credit to Anon and LSM as much as they disparaged me. I've given credit to them as much as she intentionally misconstrued everything I said. As much as Anon loyally but wrongly backed her up against me, even though I wasn't even their enemy to begin with, still I gave them credit because it's due for some of the history that I learned from them. And I still give them credit for that. Because that's me trying to be fair. Not expecting to ever be perfect, but trying to be fair. And I want to state my motive. If you really want to know, smiles, where my loyalty lies, I've already said it. It lies first, not even with just other Muslims, but with the God who created us. That's my first one. Because ain't no human being of any genotype or phenotype going to determine my death, and they're not going to resurrect me on the last day. And they're not going to be questioning me. They're going to be answering questions from the Lord, just like I will be. And we will all be petrified, afraid. All of us will be. We will wake up saying, myself, myself, brothers, mothers, children, siblings, all these bonds will be forgotten on that day, not because the people hate each other, but because they're simply so worried about themselves. We're going to be resurrected naked. And only the best of the best will be given any sort of breaks on that day. And the Lord that's going to judge us will not oppress any of us. So what I'm trying to do is act in such a way now as to make my account on that day easy. If you want to know where my first loyalty is, that's where it is. Regardless as to what someone's genotype or phenotype is, there it is. It's not even to a person. Do I get it wrong? I must. I'm human. But I do mean to be fair. To you, even if you did hate me, I mean to be fair. You said you don't, and that's great. Fine, you don't. But even if you did, I mean to be fair to you. Even if I ever had to be rough. To those who hate you, I mean to be fair to them. I will hear them out. I will hear you out if y'all choose to tell me anything. If not, okay, no biggie. See, the thing is this. I previously uploaded and said that I can't address the women's half of the golden sphere. And the second thing for which I must take accountability, smiles in a twisted MD, is that when I went into MRM's live chat, I was trying to be nice and funny, but I had already said I can't really address that half of the sphere. I could listen. They can listen to me if they want. But outside of asking a question or answering one or being invited, I can't really address them because there's not much I can say that's going to help them. There are grudges in between different camps based on their attitudes towards men. And then within the camp that doesn't hate men, there are grudges. And I can't sort them out. The women will have to. I went into MRM stream because this morning, my time, last night, yours, because she's been nice to me. I wanted to be nice to her. I didn't mind entertaining, you know, a few innocuous jokes. Before I know it, you politely corrected me about something, and I said thank you, and then we're in an argument, and you're taking every single thing that you can remember and cannot remember me saying, and you are construing it in the worst way possible. And MRM remained neutral as best she possibly could, but here's the thing, and MRM, yeah, I don't even know the name of that video, but I remember trying to explain to Anon and LSM and to my own audience how I had progressed through different stages of being pro-black and then being beyond that. And I assumed that I said, unfortunately, she came out pale-skinned or she came out light-skinned. But I do know that what I was talking about was under the teenage mindset I had, that would have been unfortunate. Whereas, of course, by the adult age at which I had my children, and I was a Muslim when I had my daughters, I thought it was obvious to people that I'm not allowed to have that sort of mindset at that point because it's not a birth defect. It's nothing that affects their health. So, I mean, at that point, yeah, thank goodness they came out healthy. I just thought people knew. Sorry for not explaining that. However, because I said it, I have to accept that you may not trust me anymore. And it's fine. I may have earned that. Even if it was an accident, I may have earned that. However, in reality, this is online. We should be able to be polite to each other, and frankly, I don't think anyone who doesn't know each other should trust or distrust, but rather to just have a wait-and-see attitude in general. And that was what I was trying to take on when it came to Smiles and to Fran, even though, and I'm talking to you both, Smiles and Fran, although this is based on whatever knowledge I have at this particular time. I've not gone into my inbox yet to see if any of you have left anything within the last 2 hours. But make a long story short, what I want to do is be fair when it comes to women's grudges, especially in light of what I said about me not being qualified to address the women's half of the manosphere outside of questions that I'm either asking or asked or by invitation. So, ladies, especially Mrs. Golden and Mrs. MRM, and to Mr. Cannon, sir, if you're ever live and I go up uninvited, it would be because backstage I'm willing to cam up, let you take a look, especially you, Mrs. Golden, because you cammed up. And you, Mrs. MRM, you have shown your baby pictures, illegally cute, by the way, and Mr. Cannon, you've cammed up. So I'd be willing to do it backstage so you can see that I am as I say I am. I wouldn't do it live, but I would do it backstage so that you could see it. And I would speak so you would know it's my voice, because I really don't mean any harm, but I don't expect you to believe that I mean harm or that I don't. I don't really expect to be trusted or distrusted. We don't know each other, and that's the truth of the matter. I do like y'all as much as you can like someone that you know online, but in all honesty, we don't personally know each other, and trusting me is a courtesy. Distrusting me would be a safe but probably overreaction, but I'm the only one that knows that you don't have to distrust me. What I meant to do in the case of you two, Mrs. Fran and Mrs. Smiles in a Twisted MD, was to be fair and to allow whichever ones of you who want to send me links to show what you have to say about the other. I'm aware y'all have a grudge. Don't get it wrong. I knew that last year. But as for how far back that grudge went, I learned that today. As for how much you all have been going back and forth, I learned that today. And there are some things that were probably said in the chat I know that I missed because, frankly, I was looking for what was ever written to me and I was busy typing. So whatever was written but not directly to me didn't show up in red, so it didn't catch my eye. So, Smiles, if somebody was telling me something and I didn't see it, forgive me. That's why. If someone did give me evidence in the chat, I just didn't see it unless they put my name in red. And I probably missed it even then because of the time I spent typing. I can't put everything into a message in a chat. I can't put everything into somebody else's live stream because I got to give people time to talk and be fair. So I have to record this, try to get as much out in a reasonable time because you know what? Fran doesn't have all the time in the world. Smiles, maybe in med school, maybe not, I don't know, doesn't have all the time in the world. So you know what? I'll try to make it short, but fair. I'm not qualified to get in on the grudge, especially without evidence. If any one of you sends evidence and then you want me to side with you, well, you know what? I'll side with the evidence. And the evidence could point to both of you being wrong. The evidence could point to even one of you being faked by the other one. Could point to that. I will say this, Smiles. You were like, look, join in my side. I was trying to say, well, both of you can send me the evidence. Otherwise, I need to fuck the shuck up. I knew I was acting like I was some kind of judge on a trial. It wasn't because I'm actually a judge or because either of you was on trial. I was doing that only to meet the judge's standard of fairness because I expect to be judged myself. That's why. That's it. If Allah asked me today or any day, why did you get involved in someone else's grudge? If you didn't know everything or taking one person's word for it, well, I wouldn't have an answer. But if he said to me, why did you not get involved? I'd be able to say, because I was waiting on either one of them to send evidence of what they had to say about the other. If they didn't send it, then I shut up because you know this stuff better than I do. You know them and I don't. You created them and I just know them as online names and faces. And maybe an email address later. I haven't checked yet. So I have to do what I'm prepared to answer for on the last day. That's what that is. I'm not saying that I'm a good Muslim. I'm just saying that I'm a serious one. And see, look, when I misremembered how many times Jesus had held a sword in his life, you politely corrected me. You showed Mrs. Smiles that you can give the benefit of the doubt. You were very polite in that. I really appreciate that. Keep this in mind. You can do the same thing when I'm simply saying I will follow the evidence when it comes to a grudge between two ladies I don't even know personally. You can do it. And the other thing, too, is that as a man, I don't fully feel welcome to comment on a grudge between two ladies. I mean, I know that there was an argument regarding you in a thread underneath one of my videos. I know that you saw it. But the thing is, I deleted that before I was on the live stream this morning. See, that thread began when I was asleep. And then it continued when I was at work. When I finished the shift at work, then I could see the whole thing. And then I sent the message to both of them that were arguing. Y'all can continue with this on your own channels at this point. Thank you so much for the info, but y'all can continue this on there, because I wasn't trying to start a new argument. What I was trying to do was be fair within the golden sphere and tell a particular man, if he ever heard me, let's refrain from calling people crispies. I did not know that he was not golden sphere. I didn't know that until the live stream this morning. There's a lot of information I just found out. I wasn't letting people disparage you per se, and I wasn't stopping them. But to be fair, the only one that asked me to go ahead and just take a side was you. I wasn't trying to side against you. I was trying to no longer take one until evidence was shown. To be fair, there is something that the same lady told me about someone else that I was able to corroborate from a different source. I still, when it came to this, I said, okay, you know what? Whoever brings me links, screenshots, or anything else, that's what I go with. Until then, I'm gonna fuck the shuck up. To be fair. See, what she sent about you, I could not prove or disprove. What she told me about two other people, one of them corroborated. So you see, then she never said, pick a side. She never did that. And you know, you may feel like I'm not for you. I don't have your best interest at heart. Well, that's part of the reason why it is, and I'm willing to address the men, and I'm gonna fuck the shuck up. And for the most part, I will address the ladies to say, hello, how you doing? The ones whom I trust so far that have been nice to me and to you. I will address them. I hope everything's going okay, because you know what? I don't expect them to be perfect either, but I do see them trying to be fair. Even when I think they're wrong, I see them trying to be fair. That's why I tip my hat to Miss MRM and to Mrs. Golden. When we disagree, we know we disagree, but there's no hatred. At least not now. I don't know, because I didn't get to see the whole live stream from this morning, my time, last night, yours, and it's not up anymore. And I don't blame her for not keeping it up. So I don't know what everything that was said, except a little snippet. I don't know everything that was said after I got off in order to go shopping. I don't know. Since I didn't hear her say anything disparaging, except, look, did you really say this, Black Mind? You know what? I don't know anything else. And she had the right to ask that question. Did I say it? I explained it, but, and I'm explaining it again. And I'm taking accountability for not making the truth obvious. I thought it was, but yeah, you know what? That's an honest mistake on my part. But what I'm trying to do is live in such a way that these mistakes of mine are honest mistakes. That's why you see me doing what I'm doing. And that's why you see me, as I grow older, becoming more careful about jumping to conclusions regarding other people's grudges when I don't know them. If Fran sends receipts, and she may, haven't checked yet, for what she says, I gotta go with them unless the receipts are weak. If you do the same, I gotta go with them unless the receipts are weak. And it may turn out that both of y'all are wrong. And you know what? In the end, it doesn't matter to me when it comes to this particular cause, because maybe, as you said, maybe I don't support it. Well, I've already stated in previous recent uploads, which you've told me you don't listen to, by the way. And that's fine. But that means you don't know. I have stated before, I support this cause to the extent of fairness and justice. MLS people, whether you believe I'm one or not, MLS people deserve to be safe from false accusations and negative untrue stereotypes. And in the United States, I learned from Anon and LSM that this is what exactly what had happened. We've been blamed for being a community of sellouts and aides to the oppressors. No, the hell we ain't been, not in the States. Not from the evidence that I've seen. By the same token, as a man, I have not experienced a lot of what you ladies have experienced, and that's not our fault, and that's not your fault. It's like somebody pulling a razor blade on you and threatening you and maybe even cutting some of your hair off and then walking past me and just looking at me up and down all crazy but not bothering me. Okay, it's not my fault they didn't, it's not my fault what they did to you and did not do to me, and it's not your fault either. We just had different experiences. I may not even know that this person is armed and doing this type of stuff with the razor blade because they didn't do it to me. Just as an example. So therefore, what I'm getting at is that there are things we just may not know. And I admit that. But I'm still willing to say that based on what the men and the women have gone through, the little bit and the lot, frankly, you deserve a safe space. I already have one. I live in the Middle East. Sometimes people say stuff here that's a little bit anti-black, including MLS, by the way. Because the black Americans aren't the only ones with a one-drop rule. It's not universal. I'm just saying that we're not the only ones. And when I say we, I'm including MLS, or rather I should say I'm including multi-generational mixed light-skinned folks, only because there's no consensus on whether or not we can be called black or not. And I don't have any recent outright white ancestors. So therefore, I don't even think mixed people would want me to call myself mixed without me saying multi-generational mixed. I'm trying to be respectful. Even if you disagreed, that's what I'm trying to do. Both of my parents are officially black. They have old passports from the 60s and 70s with the word Negro written on them. So officially they're black and I am their child. They're also not always recognizable as such. They've identified as such, that's what they know. And that's why I have said in previous recent recordings that you may not have heard that I will allow the black community of the United States under the one drop rule, which would include MLS people under the one drop rule, even though you say that it's BS, and that's fine, to decide. The two parties are going to decide what counts and what doesn't. I understand this is in a negotiation or a discussion stage. I get that. I don't live there. I don't know what's changed since I left. I'm willing to let people tell me what has changed since I left. I'm willing to let you tell me what it's like in the LA area, if that's where you still live. I don't know. Because I know that it's different there. I've admitted this before. I'm willing to check men if they make disparaging comments against light-skinned women, whether the man is light-skinned or dark. I'm willing to check them. Somebody made a comment about Brittany Renner and he tied it to a shade and I said, hold up. Her problem's not her shade. I don't agree with what she did. None of us do. But the shade is not why she did it. And this man accepted correction and said, you know what? That's right. That's true. The only thing it has to do with it is that where I live, she would have had all the options in men. That would have been true because the men here openly prefer only MLS women. So she would have had all the options. Therefore, she would have acted like this where I live too. But I don't know if that's where she even lives. So the man took correction. He said, it's not her shade that caused her to do this, and I got to be more careful. Hats off to him. This was a private conversation. I'm not going to say his name because I'm not going to out him. He took correction. I'm going to cover for him. We hashed this out, and he took it like a man. I can't stand her. I did this because it was the right thing to do. And it was perfectly okay for me to tell a particular man not to be going on other people's platforms using disparaging terms for our unmixed relatives. They are our relatives. I wouldn't let them make fun of the Wyatts, even, and I'm using the term Wyatts only to not trigger the algorithms. But I wouldn't let them go and make fun of them based on their genotype or their phenotype. That's not the problem. I am the one who says that the Western European society outside of Western Europe, or rather the Western European diaspora that went to Australia, New Zealand, the Americas, Israel, is not the moral equivalent of other people. I still say that the individuals must be taken as individuals. Why? Because this is fair. You think I want you to hate white folks? That's nonsensical. I'm not allowed to tell you to do that as a Muslim. I'm also not allowed to tell you to rank any oppressor society as moral equals to those whom they oppress. I'm not allowed to do that either. So whether I support it or not, well, you know what? That's up to you. I've already said what I support. You should not be blamed for things you didn't do and stereotype negatively in ways that are not truth. You deserve a safe space. Our unmixed relatives deserve that, although I think that does exist to a certain extent. The Western Europeans deserve that, but that place is Western Europe. Where is it for you? Maybe this place where I live is a safer place. Apparently, occasionally some people will say something about, why would you marry so-and-so? With any percentage of black blood, if they marry someone with no black blood in them, people will ask the person with no black blood why they married somebody with black blood. But it's not even based on hatred. It's just, why would you marry them? So this is a relatively safe place because here you're not characterized based on, based on your genotype or phenotype. So I'm trying to be fair again. And maybe that support that I said for those moral reasons is not enough for others in the sphere. It's up to them to decide. I never even assumed that I was accepted as a Golden Sphere member, but rather just as a supporter based on the cause of justice and fairness. That's what it's about. I happen to know the situation in the United States up to the point I left, and little bits and snippets from after I left the U.S. It is fair to not blame people for things they didn't do, whether it's me, you, or your enemies and your detractors. And that's what I'm trying to avoid. That's it. You call me hypocrite. I would have been one if I took one person's word for it and not the others. And yet and still, I could honestly say that I never caught her lying. But I did catch her telling the truth once. And in your case, I don't know you. I know less about you, but I have seen where I'll write something to you and extend an olive branch, or I'll record something, and it's like you didn't hear it. I've seen that happen before. So to be honest with you, I got one person who said something I couldn't corroborate or disprove, and then said something else I was able to corroborate with another person. And then I've got you, who I don't even know will fully comprehend everything I write or say. I mean, I think you can, but to me, the way that you respond to things I write and say, it seems like you're trying to do your homework at the same time as you're responding to me. That's what it sounds like. And to be honest with you, that's the excuse that I made for LSM. I pretty much said, you know what? I've said things and written things, and she's responded like I didn't say that. She's ignored some of the things I've said. And you know what? It's probably due to the fact that she had a small baby at that time. I made that excuse for her to give the benefit of the doubt. There are times I think about it and it makes me angry, but then I remember, you know what? YouTube. It's not real life. This is supposed to be a means to enhance somebody's real life. And things I say on here are mainly trying to enhance even your rights as they are concerned. Not our relationship. You can't stand me. I get it. You bother me too. With your low reading comprehension having self. Unless, of course, like I said, you're busy doing homework at the same time. And I heard that you're studying. And if that is the case, you could tell me, and I'd grant that excuse. But everything I've said is me trying to be fair. Me not jumping into a grudge between you and another lady, both of whom I don't really know that well, and the grudge which goes back longer than I realize, is not me being a hypocrite, ma'am. You said it yourself. You don't listen to my recent uploads. That's fine. You don't have to. I don't blame you. I don't think it's interesting to everybody, but if you don't, but you know they're there, just admit you don't know. There are things I know now I didn't know 6 months ago. And there are things I knew 6 months ago I didn't know a year and 6 months ago. As new information reaches me, I update my platform. That's what you're hearing. And I've also covered this too in recent uploads. But again, you didn't hear them, according to what you told me a while back. So just admit you don't know, and that's fine. Like I've admitted, I don't know the history of this grudge. Now, you were trusted by MRM. You were trusted by Mrs. Golden. That's fine as long as you don't abuse it. And maybe you never have. Not sure. Maybe you really believe everything you said. But if you really believe everything you said about me, then it's based on two things. One, what you told me, you don't look at my uploads at all, which means includes my recent ones. So you don't know what's changed within the last year, let alone the last half year. And then number two, because you will take everything I say and you will interpret it the worst way. But you're capable of giving the benefit of the doubt, which you did when I misremembered based on a summary. But based on a summary that I read back in the 90s about how many times Jesus had held a sword. You treated it like an honest mistake that showed me your potential. And this is why I've said that the ladies in your sphere have potential to be better and distinct from the rest of the ladies of the world, the wicked witches of the West, because every Western woman's not really a problem. It's just that the bad ones are out there. They're hyper available, just like bad dudes. Which I've also stated in previous recordings. And if you don't believe me, those of you who have listened to me, put in the comments section, have I said these things before or have I not? And if you don't know, you can say, I just don't know yet. I haven't heard it all. That's fine. But those of you who have listened before, tell me. Those of you who've been following me, if I'm wrong by what I've said before, say I'm wrong. Tell her. And if I'm right, say I'm right and tell her. Be fair, even if it's against me, but also be fair if it's for me. So that she can have some other feedback if she wants. I don't want to make this too long. Thank you so much for as long as you've been listening. I really do appreciate this from all of you, my audience members, my normal ones, those of you that are just now hearing me. Smiles if you're listening to this. And if you're not, then fine. I'm sure that some of your friends have heard, will hear this, and they'll give you a summary of what I've said. I'm not saying this out of hatred. But you have shown that you can give the benefit of the doubt. And what I've showed you, what I'm showing you, is that I'm willing to do this for you and your detractor. And I'm recording this before I even go and check my email. So, you know, certain things you didn't know, or you said you didn't know, and then you're able to remember. And Starlight, you said something about how I was never going to support the movement unless the black community kicked me out. No, I was saying I was never going to support it unless the black community as a whole told MLS people to fit the guck out. I was talking about us, because if they said this as a whole, as a minority, as a unanimous voice, then I would know, okay, you know what? That's why you got the movement. It's not about white supremacy. It's about defection, because you were told to do it. I would know then there's no question as to why you have it. You had to. You were forced, because that's fair. You didn't give me that benefit of that doubt either. And that's all I was asking for. I didn't say me, I was saying like you. See, I tried to ask Anon, and I want you and Smiles to know this. I tried to ask Anon, what percentage of the BC at large do you think wants MLS people out? What have you seen? Because they'll say things in front of you they wouldn't say in front of LSM or me. So let's be fair. You're in a position to know. I will take your guesstimation, even though there's no stat or study, I'll take your guesstimation of what percentage based on what you've seen until new information reaches me. And I was clear about this. Guess what? He told me it's worse than what I think, but he wouldn't give me a guesstimation or percentage, and he still disparaged me for my previous stances. Didn't hear me out. He was very close-minded. That's the truth. He was very loyal to LSM. I don't knock friends for being loyal to friends. But this was one time when his loyalty was misplaced. I was trying to be fair. She didn't care. Again, maybe her ability to understand was hampered by constantly having to think about her small baby. And I gave that benefit of that doubt. At the time, right about the time I expressed the benefit of that doubt, he said, "We blocked you." How come I could see it? I don't know. But I just quit going to the channel. Then later on, I found out they were down. Why would I miss them? And this is something I would say to any of you, even if we are as close to what you could call a friend online. Why would I miss them? If I came to them ready to learn, but also ready to exchange information without hostility, and they treated me with hostility, why the hell would I miss them? I have every right to be okay with them being shut down or just giving up and go. I don't care which one it is. It's not that I hate him, but would you expect me to turn the other cheek? I don't do that. I've done it before, but I don't do this indefinitely. I'm doing this now with Smiles, but it's not indefinite. I've done this with people in case they really just misunderstood. I've done this multiple times in order to make sure that I'm being fair. But this is why I said in the comments earlier in that chat to the ladies who had bad experiences with hairdressers, if these ladies were doing these things to you intentionally, then may God hurt them the way they hurt you. Even if it was minor scalp and a minor pain in the scalp, if that's what they did, then may he give the same thing to them because they were doing this to you intentionally. If they really did not know, I wouldn't say that. It's just that I have no reason to believe that they would continuously be this rough and nobody knew about it. That they were doing this to all their customers and they kept having customers. It wouldn't be sensical for me to assume that. So I took y'all at your word. I don't apologize for asking God to hurt them like the way they hurt y'all. It doesn't matter if you oppress someone by bullying them in school, or if you oppress somebody by underpaying them for the work that they do, it doesn't matter. When you oppress someone, I ask God to punish you. And if I oppress someone, I ask God to punish me too. If it's an accident, it's an accident. But when you do it, you know you're doing it, I ask God to punish. What I say in the morning, believe it or not, y'all ain't gonna believe this, but I actually say to my Lord, I seek refuge in you from oppressing others and being oppressed, from misleading others and being misled, and from deceiving others and being deceived. This is one of the things I say in the morning. It's not every morning, but it's pretty much a habit. I say one of the first things I say. I usually say this even before I start to record. Not because I'm perfect, but because it is my job to be fair. Because you don't deserve, even if you can't stand me, you don't deserve to be blamed for things you didn't do. And neither does anybody else on any end of the spectrum or any race or any genotype or phenotype. Even if their civilization is trash because of the morality or the immorality of it, the individuals don't deserve to be blamed for things they didn't do. And even a civilization shouldn't be blamed for things they didn't do. I've said before that from all evidence, Western Europeans did not really start color prejudice. Apparently it came from some Eurasians. It's based on what somebody from that region told me, that he knew the people who started color prejudice. He told me this himself. He's from Afghanistan, and he said that the people who did this were from the boundary of what is now between Afghanistan and Iran, but they were called the Aryan people. They did start this, and Hitler took the name, named his movement after them. He called them Aryans, or in English they called them that, but they called themselves Aryan. The guy that told me, he said that there was a point in time in their history in which they achieved a very high material standard of living based on resources. And first they discriminated against other people based on that because they just made better stuff, or they could buy better stuff and they just made better houses. But then later on, they began to discriminate based on shade. That's how he explained it to me. So I pretty much said, I'm not going to hold that Western Europeans started it. They accelerated it and exacerbated it, but they didn't start it. Why? Because based on the information I've been given, that's fair. I hope this explains a lot. I really do. If any of you don't trust me, that's fine. I was willing to sacrifice credibility with some people in the manosphere by giving Golden Sphere a fair chance. And I don't regret that. Fair is fair. And if somebody wants to doubt me because I'm trying to be fair, that's fine. And it's the same thing here. If someone wants to doubt me here because my intention was to be fair, that's fine. Because in the end, don't get it twisted. I support the cause for a reason many of you may not know. Because from all the information that has reached me, it is right. Not everything everybody says in there is going to be right. Hell, I misremembered how many times Jesus held a sword, apparently. I'll go back and look and check. But even well-meaning people can make an honest mistake. I did it. So I certainly don't expect anything everyone, including myself, says to be correct. However, my reasons for supporting it, it ain't about selfishness. Because I can turn around and tell a Palestinian, if he says anything negative about black folks, I can call him all kind of rat bastard racist and still sympathize with him when the Israelis oppress him. Why? Fair is fair. Wrong is wrong. Even when I do it. So I'm taking accountability here from the beginning that you heard. Even though it was an honest mistake, it was stupid on my part. wasn't malicious, but boy, was it dumb. I gotta own up to that. There was something else I want to take accountability for. I just can't remember what it is. So if I do a part two, that's probably going to be what it is. Or if maybe I'll put it in the comment section underneath if it comes back to me. But, no, if any of you other ladies all of a sudden don't trust me, fair enough. It's fine. Just don't trust or distrust anybody automatically. Check everyone. And if anybody wants to come to you and tell you something bad about somebody else, then they have every right. They can say something because they saw it, but you also have every right to say, I'm not going to jump to any negative conclusions about you or them until I see some evidence. You got a right to do that, even if it's me telling you about someone. I may tell you, be careful. I may do that because I'm supposed to tell you. But even if I say this to you and you say, I just want to see evidence, it's my job to either come with it or just say, you know what? I don't have it. I don't have a recording of it. So just have a backup plan. And if it turns out to work out okay, great. That's a fair thing to say. But I don't plan on doing that, honestly, unless, I've already explained that part. My reason is because I love your rights. It's not because I love or hate y'all that I'm supporting this. Although there are those of you that I do like. I mean, it's not appropriate for me to say to some of, to the ladies or to the men that I love you because I'm a married man and I'm hetero. But more importantly than liking you, which I do for many of you, is that I love your rights and I respect your rights. That's what it's about. I don't live there. My kids do, but they're probably going to join me. That's the plan. So this is not about me. It's not even about them. It's about what is right for you because you're still there and you're still going through that struggle. And the people that are doing these things or saying these things to you, whether it's verbal or physical, they're also traumatized. And I admit that, but that doesn't mean they got a right to turn around and take it out on you. And you were very right. Many of you were very right when you said they want to take out on you their actual frustrations on somebody that oppressed them. Not only someone on the opposite, not only someone of an entirely different race from them, but even people on the same side of the spectrum within the same race as them who had a problem with the way they looked and put it on them and were hard on them and then they won't take it out on you. That's not okay. They need a healing, but that doesn't make it okay for them to bleed on you. It is your rights. It is the justice that I love more. And it's actually your rights I fear. If I trample them, if I help anybody trample on them, I expect to have to answer. And if I help somebody trample on somebody else's rights, even if they hate you, but I help someone trample on their rights, I expect to be punished for it. Because you see, when you sin against God out of human weakness, you repent only to him. And if it's sincere, he accepts it. When you sin against another person and violate their rights, you don't have to repent just to God. You got to repent to that person, and they may not forgive. And they may not know if you're sincere or not. So this is about me being able to say later on that I use my tongue in respect of everyone's rights. That's what it's about. It's like what my friend said, and then I'm gonna bounce and leave. It's like a friend of mine said to me long time ago. When I first got to the city in which I now live, he gave me a lift, which was quite a ride. He gave me a lift to the closest city that had an airport. He drove me there and he drove himself back. And he volunteered to come pick me up when I had to come back in. Now, at that point, I was going to be flying to North Africa. And that was the last time that I saw my wife in North Africa, the North African wife, last time. We wound up actually having an argument about race relations. It's the only time I ever raised my voice at her. Never had to before. And she was a light-skinned black North African woman. I mean, if you can call it such. When she requested a divorce 10 days after I last saw her, I thought she was requesting it. No, 8 days after. 10 days after the argument. When she requested it, I thought she was requesting it based on the argument. And I was like, well, if that's your reason, good riddance. Know why? Because it is not okay for her to look down on the black race in general. It's not okay. She can look down on anybody's cultural practices, but everybody's culture sucks. Mine, my wife's people's culture sucks, the Arab's culture sucks, everybody's culture sucks because we all need guidance. And human beings tend to put greed over guidance in many cases, and tradition over morality in many cases. So when this man drove me to the airport, I was thanking him profusely because that was a long, you know, fairly long haul. And he said, "You look, you're very welcome, but I don't think you understand why I'm doing it." I said, "Well, what's it about?" And he said, "I'm not doing this for you." Yeah, you are a nice guy, but I'm not doing this for you. And he put his finger up. Now, I know what that means. When he put his finger, held one finger up, he was saying one God. And it was for his sake that he was doing these good deeds. He was doing it to score points with God. That was a reminder to me that when I do good things, it's to, in order to be for God. So when I speak on your behalf of your rights, and you should not be blamed for things you didn't do, and you should be safe somewhere, you know what? That's what it's about. Smiles. Now, I would say this, I would say the same thing to Fran, but the thing was that Fran didn't get on my case that I saw. If she did, I never saw it. She wasn't taking every single thing I said and trying to twist it around. And I'm not saying this to say I'm going to take a side in a grudge. Unless, of course, she brings the evidence and you don't. Or vice versa. Then the result would be, then I would take the opposite conclusion. But even if I take whatever conclusion I take, I've already said that until I am invited, I'm going to fuck the shuck up and stop addressing the ladies in the sphere, except for asking questions or being invited to answer one or being invited to a discussion. And I was already wrong for not holding to that this morning. And I paid for it. So even if she sends the receipts, you don't, or even if you send the receipts and she doesn't, between the two of you, I may say, okay, well, this is the one I can most believe, but I'm not going to say this publicly. I ain't got no business delving in other people's grudges anyway, especially after I said I'm going to stop addressing them until being advised, until being invited to, or until I have a question. Fair is fair. I got to keep my word, right? I just took accountability for what I did wrong, so I better start doing right. And part of that means keeping my word. That was it. That's the second thing I remember now. Second thing I need to take accountability for was that I did not keep my word this morning. I meant to be friendly because MRM is friendly and she's fair. Not always right, but she does mean to be fair. And I thought, you know what? I got the notification she was on. Let me wave good morning. That's what I meant to do. But when I think about it now, I mean, what I meant to do was nice. When I think about it, she's doing well without me. If I pass away tomorrow, she's going to keep on, and she don't need me to be a battery in her back. She doesn't need any of us to. She's doing this out of conviction. For that, God bless her. And if she said anything later on after I quit listening to the show, she's upset with me, more than likely she would tell me. She's not afraid. I didn't hear if she did, but if it ever came to that, she would tell me. Golden told me what she disagreed with, although I wasn't blaming her at all for what somebody on her live said. She told me I still felt like I was being judged for what someone else said. And I explained, not by me. Maybe someone did, but it wasn't going to be me, because how you going to know what he says till he says it? Granted, yeah, I would have said something at the time, but I'm a different person. I'm not blaming her for that. I don't know that she didn't say anything in private. She may have told him in private, and I would never know about it because she doesn't have to tell any of us what she said to him. However, that's what he said. That's what he said. She already made it plain earlier on. She's not starting grudges. Somebody else might, but she's not doing it. She made that part plain. Straight up. And I'm going to say this in order to be fair. Some of you men that want to get on me about trying to be fair to the golden sphere. If you're a manosphere and you want to get on my case about trying to be fair to the golden sphere, fuck the shuck up. I didn't say they were perfect. But if that's the thing, unsubscribe. Even though I later on decided that, you know what, there's not much I can tell the ladies there. It's just not much I could say because they're going to sort this out on their own. They obviously don't need us. Even though I've said this, you got to understand that I was not wrong for giving them a fair shot from the beginning. I did the same thing with the Manosphere. I gave them a fair shot. They passed it. You passed it collectively. It wasn't because I agree with every single conclusion everyone drew, but the premises for the conclusions were valid, and you allowed people to draw other conclusions if the premises were valid. And so I said, okay, well, you know, fear, this fear overall, it's at least a mix, but the premises are valid, so I'm gonna get in it. That's why. I give a fair chance, and that bothers you, whichever sphere you're in, then unsubscribe. Because in the end, understand this, I'm not gonna be judging you on the last day, and you ain't gonna judge me. I'm not one of those that says only God can judge me, but whatever I make obvious and open, you can judge me for that. It's a preliminary judgment, it only stands until the last day in the final judgment, but whatever I make open and obvious, the good or the bad, you can judge me for that. Preliminarily, initially. And I'm going to do the same thing, starting with myself. And whatever you all make open and obvious, I'm going to judge you for that. I'm judgmental. But I start with me, and I end with me too. Because I'm the one that's got to experience my own judgment, the final one. And if you were upset with because I tried to make a decision that I could live with and that I could defend on the final day if I was ever questioned about it. And remember this, God does not oppress anybody. Keep that in mind. So is he really going to roast and grill and cook me because of something I was trying to do the right way? Starting with worshiping him to the exclusion of anyone or anything else. And ending with respecting the rights of his creation that he gave to his creation. The way I would want mine to be respected by other creations. You think he's going to punish me for that? He may not even ask. And that's what my motivation is, whether y'all understand it or not. Oppression is wrong, no matter who does it. Last thing I'll tell you is this. Smiles, in case you didn't understand. You think I had something against my daughters, but no, they look like me and they look like my mom and my dad. The hell, they look like my brother. Why would I have something against them? As an adult, as a Muslim at that, by that point, no. Okay, granted, I said, unfortunately, although I thought that it was obvious I was talking about a teenage standpoint, but nonetheless, if it puts you to rest, because you do care about other people, apparently, especially other ladies, which is fine. If it helps you, understand that on my last trip, and I'm about to tell you some family business so that it can help soothe your conscience and you're worried about anybody else. On my last trip to the States, my parents, my daughters, and I sat down and we discussed this. I asked my daughter, what have you dealt with? My younger daughter was there. I asked my oldest daughter, though, in front of her, so that my younger daughter could get some preparation herself. I said to the oldest daughter, sweetheart, what have you dealt with since the day that you were at that function with your Nigerian play cousin and another fella came up to you and said, what are you doing here? This is for Africans. And when you said that you were of African origin, he was like, don't know Africans look like you, which is not true. What have you faced since that time? And she said to me, which was actually good news. She told me, I really haven't faced much. Some people don't necessarily know what I am till I tell them. But for the most part, I really haven't faced much. In my school, there is a black student union at my school. She's not even in a college yet. She's in high school. She said, there is a black student union at my school. We have meetings sometimes. And to be honest with you, this isn't one of the issues. We talk about other stuff. For the most part, we treat each other equally. She said to me, it doesn't seem like it's not there like it is, like it was here for you growing up. Because we were in my hometown and my parents' house. She said, it's not like what it was for you growing up. And I wondered how she knew how it was for me growing up. And she said, well, that my son had told her. And she said to me also, I remember some of the talks that you had. I remember some of the things you said years ago back when you lived here to your own, you know, to my grandparents and to your brother, to my uncle. I remember some of those things. But it hasn't been that way in the north where I'm living. We still talked about it. And you know, the thing is, my father and mother began to tell her how to prepare for the day that she does have to face some of this discrimination and questioning and differentiated treatment. I was going to, but they began to speak, and since they're older, they've dealt with it longer than I have, I fucked the shuck up. But the last thing I said to them regarding that was, understand this too. When you start having to deal with this, do not be afraid to tell either of us adults. You have to deal with it in college. Don't be afraid to tell either of us that this is what you have to deal with. And we'll walk you through it. And if you don't feel comfortable telling granddad or me or your brother, you can ask grandma. And she said, I certainly will if it comes to that. I trust y'all. I hope this puts your mind at rest regarding her. Since you do seem to care about the children, like I do. Thank y'all for listening. The peace greeting is probably not appropriate, so I'm not going to do it on the way out either. But until next time, folks.